Matt Panto here for GirlLeopards.com, Patriot League Media Day 2013. Just a great day so far, and we want to catch up with the guys that you'll be hearing and seeing all season long. Our team on the Lafayette Sports Network, Gary Loblock, John Leone, Mike Joseph. Guys, welcome back. Certainly hope everybody had a great summer. Football season right around the corner. Gary, obviously a lot of excitement coming into this year. You just had the opportunity to talk to Coach Devani, talk to the three student athletes. What impressed you most in getting ready for this season?
Well, I too came back for the summer. I've been working out, and I feel like I want to hit you, actually.
Yeah.
So I'm ready to
hurt.
Go. Yeah, I am definitely ready to go. Coach Devani, of course, it's still early, and you know, we'll all get over to some practices and watch the team develop. Me, I want a better offense. The offense has been inconsistent the last couple of years. I want a consistent offense because that creates a lot of excitement, especially for us up in the booth and John down in the field.
Same feeling?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I think so. The thing that's intriguing to me, obviously, it's the first year that Lafayette's going to have scholarships. And I remember asking the question of Coach, and I probably didn't clarify it very well. I said, what about a learning curve? And I was talking about a learning curve. Sometimes we watch kids come into the program, Michael, non-scholarship kids, and they take time. Will the learning curve be shorter? What Frank said to me was he started talking about the learning curve of the coaches, how to recruit with scholarships. That's an interesting
sure.
concept.
That would have been a problem for you, John.
Yeah,
smarter kids.
They come in with so much athletic ability. Sometimes you got to find a spot for a kid. I mean, especially with some kids we've lost over the summer, and you may have a freshman that comes in and jumps ahead and say, wow, we can use this kid. So more on offense. But, you know, and Gary said he's looking for offense. I'm looking to stop the run defensively. Yeah. I mean, that 200 yards a season, a game, every year for the last 3 years. You got to stop the run. And we're going to have a good secondary, great linebackers running around, 11 guys back on offense. But defensive line-wise, we've got to stop the run. If we don't do that, it's going to be a long season.
Well, let's dissect that a little bit, because two parts to that. Number one, you always say that freshmen can maybe make their most immediate impact on special teams. Let's start with special teams. Is that where they kind of fit in this year off the bat, with the exception of one or two that might see the two deep?
Well, our special teams haven't been very good either, especially last year. So it is an area of concern coming into the football season. And one would hope we're getting a lot more athletic individuals because of the scholarships. And that's the feeling the coaches have about these kids. So, yes, I think they will make an impact on the special teams. And I'm hoping one or two of them make an impact on the offense and defense.
Yeah, you know, my impression, the special teams obviously has been, you know, a weakness. But I think it goes back to being able to run the football. How many times, if you were to chart, this is a sense, unscientific, but third down and short, how many times we fail to convert when now the special teams group has to come on the field when ordinarily they wouldn't. I think there's just been too many occasions for them when we have to convert on third
and
short.
Where's the big bruising running back that's going to get that first down and not have to change personnel and throw the football out of the gun on third and one and third and two? You got a 6'5 quarterback, maybe some little Tom Brady quarterback sneak. I mean, things that can remove the chains and keep them on the field, because three and outs are going to be a killer, because you don't want that defense, especially, like I said, being able to have to take on 75, 85 plays a game, because it's going to wear down.
And by the way, we never consider any of John's answers scientific. So when he says unscientific, it's a waste of words.
It's a given. Yeah. It's a given. Hey, talking about scholarship, guys, Michael, probably you, because you've coached the game, you've played the game. Where do you see the scholarship kids making the quickest, most impact?
Yeah, well, like Matt said, I think it's got to be at the wide receiver position. It's got to be on special teams in the secondary. Can a kid return punts, kickoffs? You get a scholarship offensive lineman, I think you got to develop that kid, become a redshirt freshman. Offensive line-wise, I mean, we got a lot of guys, and Matt and Brad mentioned it, we got a lot of guys coming back. But you can make an immediate impact if a guy gives you a chance to run down on a kickoff. The guy gives you a chance to catch a punt. Punt. We're going to have another kicker coming in. So at the skill positions, it makes a bigger sense. But I tell you what, we're going to see it in the booth. You're going to see kids faster, stronger, bigger, making plays. And we're going to sit around and go, wow, we haven't seen that. And all of a sudden, there it is right in front of our eyes.
And Mike and I like to high five in the booth. So we want to see those kind of plays. Although he's been injured all summer.
Yeah.
He may have to be a low five.
Yeah. You talked about stopping the run, Mike, on defense, and you switched to that side of the ball. Going into last year, defensive line, Ricky Lister, Jason Marshallek, Tahir Basile, kind of a strength of that team.
Yes.
Now, guys are still there, but maybe some underclassmen that haven't seen the experience yet. Where do you guys look when you turn to the defense?
I just turned to those the secondary. 22 interceptions. Remember last year we filed the first six games. It was takeaway city. I mean, it was just
you
so much fun.
You thought your record was in jeopardy.
I did, and then it kind of peeled back a little bit. But those linebackers, remember how big question mark those linebackers were, and we were so impressed with all of them, and a couple kids got hurt, Mike Bowles, and I mean, they're going to come along. But defensive line-wise, you got to be able to line up every so often, and John Luce will find a way. You know, run a little 46, run a little 4-3, a little 3-4. He'll change it up enough. But can you load up on third and one and get off the field?
Yeah, and that's where it goes back to your point, Michael, about athleticism and where guys can make impact. I look for the linebacking crew to really take a big step up. We've lost some of the big names. We have been mini linebacker U, if you will, for the last few years. But I just think that with the ability to attract kids with scholarship, mm-hmm. the facilities, getting the right kid in the right school, in the right program, I just think we're going to see an emergence of the linebacking crew.
And that's going to be huge. Lest we forget, the entire Patriot League is getting scholarships. So it's going to be a matter of who gets the best kids. And I know we've gone all over the United States to find some good football players, so we've done a good job.
Gary, to that point, that's why I say, you know, I think all things considered, the scholarship playing field is level, but in terms of facilities, I challenge any school in the Patriot League
absolutely.
To match ours. When we interviewed John Gruden, and here's a guy that's been with the elite, he's been with the best elite around that place, and he said, this is unbelievable.
Yeah.
So I think that long time coming, but the scholarship issue.
And John's being very modest. We didn't interview John. He brought it up because
John Gruden.
And it's been on GoLeopards.com now for ad nauseum, I think.
And let's not leave out our coaches. Well, those guys have an unbelievable staff. And that's been together a long time.
Yeah.
Frank's kept these guys here.
Yeah.
That's a hard thing to do. You know, all these guys get calls. They all know where the openings are. And to still have Mickey Fine and to still have John Luce and still have, the running back coaches and guys. We lost the wide receiver coach, I think, this year.
Yep.
And,
Marcel.
And that's going to be a loss because Marcel did a lot of stuff behind the scenes. He's very good with the kids and stuff. So,
but a Lafayette alum.
And a Lafayette alum.
Understood the program.
To keep those kids intact and have to vote Coach Devani here in that first year of scholarships is huge. So you got to give some real credit to that coaching staff.
Let me wrap it up with this. Put yourself in that coaching staff's shoes in the first week of preseason. We'll talk at our media day a little bit later. But put yourself in that coaching staff's shoes for the first week of this preseason camp. Overall goals, 1 and 2, that have to get done in the first week of this camp.
Well, I think, first of all, they're going to come in absolutely excited because they've got scholarship kids there on the field. I think their major goal is attitude. You want to create an attitude about a football team that gives them a sense that they're going to have themselves a winning season. A Sacred Heart is right around the corner. Let's get that first win. Let's start feeling positive about ourselves. You can work on the basics and fundamentals, but attitude is something you need from day one.
I'll go a different angle here. I think striking a balance between live action, physical play, getting the reps you need, and keeping people healthy, particularly the quarterbacks. We don't have a lot of depth at quarterback.
Nope, not a lot of depth, and I'll give you two, Swisig and Ross.
Yeah.
Make it happen.
Which
all
one?
Year long, give a chance for your offense to answer if your defense can't step up, and Swisig and Ross.
So you're talking Mark Ross.
I'm talking Mark Ross, and I'm talking Swisig, and those kids are outstanding, and I'm looking forward to Zach having a huge season.
In a word or less, Gary, figure it out. Biggest key to the 2013 season?
Swisig.
Short running game.
John. It's not one word. We'll let you slide.
It wasn't scientific.
I can't put it down to one word. Stop the run.
Okay.
There you go.
Fair enough. I'm going to go with depth. Coach Devani has talked about all season long how he likes the depth of this team all summer long, I should say.
You don't want to know how we prepare?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Not at all. We'll find that out on media day. Looking forward to it. They're preparing. We are preparing 2013 football season for Lafayette football right around the corner. We thank our Lafayette Sports Network team. Matt Panto from Patriot League Media Day.